When you're looking around online trying to make important decisions on what to get in order to survive the apocalypse, many things just seem to be a waste of money. There's all kinds of high-tech gear out there you can buy, but if you forget the basics, good luck not becoming zombie food. Whether you're deciding to camp out in the mountains or considering a home fortress, there will be things you must own in order to properly be prepared. Here is the most essential equipment to survive the zombie apocalypse. Number 16, a bug out bag. Depending on how quickly the zombie apocalypse is spreading, you may or may not want to leave your home. It's often a topic of debate, and we'd like to hear what our audience thinks about this question. But if you're living in the city where the virus spreads quickly, you probably want to make a break for it to a rural area. You won't have a ton of time to pack your bags like you do if you're going away for vacation, and those little rolly briefcases aren't going to cut it. This really isn't supposed to carry enough for you to survive the rest of your life in the woods. The goal here is to carry enough things for you to make the journey to your next destination by foot, or to survive a couple days, maybe a week, in the wilderness until things settle down. You can also consider this to be your supply bag in case your zombie apocalypse vehicle breaks down in the middle of nowhere. This means a sturdy backpack, preferably camouflage. One brand that works great is known as Dwight Shoe Hunting Bags. They're complete with plenty of pockets like you see in this photo. In this video, we'll mention a few things you should certainly keep in this bug out bag. Number 15, a hatchet. Now that you got yourself a survival bag, you need to find a few things to put in it. A hatchet is going to prove to be an essential tool for every outdoorsman for many different reasons. Obviously, the hatchet makes for a great zombie killing weapon for close combat and for stealth kills, but you'll probably find plenty of ways to make this thing useful. If you're planning on heading out to a forest such as Yosemite, this will prove useful for cutting up firewood and maybe even fighting off bears if you have to. Hatchets can also be turned into hammers once you flip it around. Number 14, machetes. Depending on where you live exactly, a machete like this one could prove to be extremely effective as a weapon and also a tool. If you plan on escaping the city, you may be surrounded by tropical jungles with vines, tree limbs, and zombie monkeys who are trying to eat your brains. If you end up needing to run away, a machete will certainly help you clear a path from pesky tree limbs and branches. Machetes are light, mobile, extremely sharp, and will easily cut through decaying flesh of zombies. However, maintaining them and keeping them constantly sharp may be an issue. Either way, it's a great addition to your arsenal. Some, like this one here, may even come with saws, which could make it more useful in tasks such as gathering firewood. It's usually good to have at least one machete or a hatchet. Both maybe isn't necessary. Number 13, purification tablets. The most vital resource all humans need to own is certainly water, and there's a few different ways to go about doing this. These will certainly save your life. Don't be fooled by the fast water myth. Even fresh-looking waterfalls can still have parasites or fecal matter that are waiting to infect you. And who knows if a zombie is lying around upstream. Iodine tablets will work great and are cheaper, but there's still a strange taste to it which will often need to be neutralized. The other more preferable method of purifying your water is chlorine dioxide, which is not only more effective, but will pretty much make it taste like tap water. However, they will need a longer treatment time, which is about 4 hours, in comparison with the 30 minutes of iodine. Each tablet can purify up to a quart of water each. In order to ensure a long time with consistent water purification, a life straw is also recommended, which can make any nasty water almost taste like bottled water instantly. Be sure that none of the untreated water gets stuck in the area where you twist the cap. Number 12, collapsible water bottles. Yes, we understand that having a cool, fancy water bottle right now might seem like a luxury, but the truth is, if you can't store and transport your water, you're in big trouble. Especially if you have to dash away from some mindless zombies. Don't worry so much about food at the beginning, it will be water that keeps you alive longer. The only problem that a water bottle poses, however, is that it can take up quite a bit of space in your bag. This is why having something like a hydropack collapsible water bottle would be a good choice while trying to survive the apocalypse. While plastic water bottles can do the same thing, they're not quite as durable and can easily be punctured. These can fold up and take up incredibly small amounts of space when water isn't being stored. It's so small, you can even keep it in your pocket. Number 11, fire starters. fire is another essential thing that you absolutely must have to cook. Matches, lighters, waterproof matches are never a bad thing to invest in, but let's say all your matches are gone and you've used up all your fuel. Now what? Luckily, there's an invention called the Swedish Army Fire Steel that will help you survive the wilderness and keep you from being a savage and allow you to start a fire. This instrument instantly creates a spark that measures at 3,000 degrees Celsius. Just one of these will last up to 12,000 sparks, so it almost seems like a crime to not have one of these in your bug out bag. Companies that advertise about 3,000 strikes normally are more efficient in starting a big fire with just one strike. Find something that will catch on fire quickly like a cotton ball and Vaseline and use that striker to hit the fire steel. Before you know it, you got yourself a pretty good fire. Number 10. A poncho. Don't underestimate the simple power of a poncho and what it can do for you. Lightweight and easy to pack, ponchos can serve more purposes than keeping you dry. If you're creative enough, you probably could use a few ponchos to make yourself a tent or a shelter in a rainy environment. Keeping things dry is extremely important, considering the fact that moisture will lead to fungal and microbial infections. Ponchos are often utilized by the military and other survivalists. It's a versatile item that should be kept in your survival kit. They're also available for dogs in case your dog likes fighting zombies. Number 9. Personal care. We understand that you aren't going on vacation and you probably won't be going on any dates anytime soon, but you still need to make an attempt to keep up with your daily hygiene to prevent illness. And if you go a long time without using a few of these personal care items, it can lead to serious problems very quickly. Consider bringing a comb to prevent your hair from knotting and to combat against bugs. Your toothbrush and toothpaste will help you from getting cavities, and you better believe teeth will certainly be tricky to get fixed during the apocalypse. Stuff like this should be included with your first aid kit, which contains plenty of bandages, disinfectants, ointments, and ways to disinfect yourself. Number 8. Survival Paracord Bracelet. Ropes will become more useful than you can even imagine. You might need to climb up cliffs, hang your clothes to dry, or even hogtie a hostile trespasser. Now imagine being able to store up to 3 meters of sturdy, valuable paracord just on your wrist. It only weighs about 20 grams and unravels to nearly 10 feet in length, and they're also quite stylish. Paracords will prove to be useful for rock climbing, setting shelters, traps, and even keeping your supplies above ground to avoid moisture. It might not be the most sturdy rope to use for rock climbing, but if it's an emergency, it could be your only choice. If you got a little extra space on your wrist, we'd suggest any survivalist to pick this one up. Number 7. Hand crank flashlight. Battery-operated flashlights would of course be ideal, and it's also never a bad idea to stock up on batteries, especially if you plan on going the home prepper strategy. However, hand crank flashlights are praised for their reliability and are always ready to help you prepare for the unknown dark world you may have to enter. There are no batteries required and all you gotta do is crank it. These are recommended for disaster situations when power goes out and for hikers when they go out at night. After a good 6-minute crank, it'll be sure to stay lit for at least an hour. These are actually pretty cheap and they certainly seem like something you need to keep in your bug out bag, especially if you have to run from zombies late at night. Number 6. Duct tape. In what possible way could duct tape be useful in the zombie apocalypse? More like, in what ways are they not? First of all, duct tape works great for setting up zombie traps and it can certainly be used to set up tripwires. Also, let's say that one of your friends has become bitten by a zombie and you know it'll only be hours before they start to go crazy and try to start eating you. You might find this a little bit easier than shooting your best friend in the head with a shotgun. Duct tape can also be used for securing weak parts in your home, used for armor, clothing, repair your equipment, or even tape shut a mouth of a zombie, which might be hard. There's just so many ways to use it and you don't always know when you're gonna need it or why. It's just best to have it. Number 5. Crowbar. The crowbar is another essential tool that will prove to be quite useful in an apocalyptic world. During your journey throughout the apocalyptic wasteland, you may come across a few crates or doors that need to be opened in order to loot the supplies. Crowbars allow you to deconstruct objects carefully, so you can even loot the nails if you need them. This simple metal tool is extremely cheap and can be made from valuable metals. Looting is going to be one of your best ways to gather supplies, and if you're not a professional locksmith, a good old crowbar will get the job done. Many rave about the crowbar's effectiveness as a zombie weapon as well. Some might even modify it with duct tape for extra grip. The hook of the crowbar adds extra damage to the skull, which should be pretty lethal to a zombie and could be one of the best weapons to finish off a wounded zombie. One or two swings should be all it needs. Number 4. Video camera. Most electronics won't be too useful, and you might run out of battery at some point, but a video camera can prove to be useful, especially if you're working as a team. If you're able to videotape a zombie, scientists will be able to study it, and you'll be able to understand better the symptoms of the virus yourself. You can also learn about better ways to exterminate them, as well as how to protect yourself. Other cameras may prove to be useful with the addition of infrared or night vision to help you navigate your way through the dark. Some useful items, like a power pot, which runs on boiling water, can generate enough electricity to power charge your electronics. Number 3. Armor. It's not just zombies you're gonna have to worry about during the zombie apocalypse. It's people you're gonna have to watch out for too. And people know how to use guns. If you're able to come across some kind of bulletproof vest during your journey through the apocalyptic world, you may certainly want to take it. Although you can possibly survive the apocalypse with no armor, having armor will be crucial if you consider taking over another human outpost who has a large stockpile of weapons, food, ammunition, water, etc. Number 2. Swiss Army Knife. Any kind of knife is certainly going to be useful, but it doesn't always need to be used as a weapon. Knives used as weapons during the zombie apocalypse can put you a little bit too close to the infected. Some Swiss Army knives are equipped with wire cutters to help you clip through chain link fences. They can also feature useful tools like saws and hammers to aid you in constructing a stronghold. Don't forget about the steel serrated straight blades that will cut through zombie flesh with ease. Firearms do take a lot of cleaning and ammunition, which might make it difficult to maintain. Swiss Army knives such as the Mutt EOD multi-tool is designed to work in harmony with weapons such as the AR-15, which will help you clean, maintain many different firearms, especially those used by the military. This army knife has useful tools and weapons that will help you from becoming zombie food. This gadget will cost you around $169, but it could well be worth it. And number 1. Firearms. We all know the setbacks with firearms during the zombie apocalypse. The noise can attract too many zombies and give away your location, but you're basically a sitting duck without one during the zombie apocalypse. Relying solely on melee weapons will prove to be a bad choice, especially if you find yourself in the middle of a zombie swarm. One of them will get you eventually. But if you're skilled enough to aim for the head each time and hit your target, this could at least give you enough time to run away. Silencers are also an option if you know how to make one or if you're able to purchase it. Guns will certainly make hunting easy if you find yourself in the woods for a long period of time, and it's good to get yourself something powerful but lightweight. Something like a Glock 9mm, an AR-15, or a Desert Eagle are all great choices. First, consider acquiring the basics, then you can finally move on to more high-tech fancy gear that will ultimately lead to your survival during the zombie apocalypse. Thanks for watching, and be sure to hit that subscribe button for new videos every day.